Welcome to my Airbnb here in Austin, Texas. The lime scooter capital of the country, probably, and a place that's known for its barbecue, but we're looking for something a little bit different this time around. We are on the hunt for the best breakfast tacos and the ones that are the best deal, so don't go far. We're gonna kick it off with my old standby, Vera Cruz Tacos. Now they've expanded a lot recently and have locations all around town, but we are going to the newer one in East Austin. This is right by one of my favorite bars, Kitty Cohen's. They built this beautiful courtyard. The ambiance is great, but let's get into the tacos. We're gonna start with the migas taco. It's basically eggs, tortilla chips, and cheese. I'm gonna get this everywhere we go. This is gonna be our baseline for judging all these taco spots. And just for good measure, I also got the migas poblanas, which has roasted poblano peppers, and then they give you great salsas with these. Huge tortilla chips in there, great flavor. Not as big as I remember, but super good. Vera Cruz was the whole inspiration behind this video. Every time we went to Austin, we would have to go to Vera Cruz Tacos. I remember waiting in line for over an hour every single time and not being able to finish more than two tacos. This time, I don't know. It was really nice to be able to order online and just pick it up, not have to wait an hour in the heat. But the tacos themselves weren't as earth-shattering as I remember them being. A little bit of salt would have gone a long way. And it was $3.75 for the migas and $4.25 for the migas poblanas. And the size of those tacos, I could have finished three or four. I don't know if it's because if you wait in line for something for an hour, it's just gonna taste that much better. Or if it's that story of that small place that just got too big. Don't get me wrong, it's still a great spot. If I'm at Kitty Cohen's, I might pop in for a taco, but I'm not gonna go out of my way for it. And I definitely couldn't see myself waiting in line for an hour.
The second spot is new to me. It's called Tacos Guillermo. It got 4.7 stars on Google, so we figured we had to check it out. It's also in East Austin, right off Cesar Chavez, in the parking lot of an insurance company. And to mix it up, we got their Nopales taco, or cactus, along with the migas. And right off the bat, both of these are twice the size of Vera Cruz tacos. There was a nice little waterfront park right down the road to eat them. And both of these tacos were really well seasoned. I think the migas taco just hit the spot a little bit more than the cactus taco. It was loaded with fresh chilies, eggs, and tortilla chips. But both of these were great value for what we paid and very filling.
I've definitely driven by this place a couple times and never paid any attention to it. It is very unassuming, but the value here was spectacular. Every taco was only $3 and they were huge. I definitely couldn't eat more than two. I think that they're more known for their savory tacos, like the tacos al pastor and things like that. But if you're in the area, definitely stop by for Amigos Taco. It's very good and it'll fill you up.
At this next spot, we were craving something savory, so we drove just a couple minutes north and right next to two of the best barbecue spots in Austin, if not the country, and one of my favorite bars, Nickel City, is a small white trailer called Tacos de Descada. They only do one thing, but they do it really well, and that is taquitos with a mix of marinated braised beef and pork and a side of elote. The taquitos themselves are topped with pineapple, cilantro, and onions. They're super juicy and flavorful, and if you come up here, you absolutely have to get the corn. Both of us said that, hands down, these were the two favorite bites of food that we had all day, a must visit.
This spot's definitely more on the hipster spectrum as far as tacos go, but you got three taquitos for $5.50, or five for $9, so just under $2 each. And they were super packed with flavor. They came with pickled shallots and salsa. The corn, if you want it, was another $5 for the side, but absolutely worth it. I would definitely go out of my way to come here again.
Just when I thought I was done, I found one more spot. It was rated 4.9 stars on Google. It's called Granny's Tacos. It just happened to be right down the road from our Airbnb. Of course I had to get the migas taco, but then I also threw in the machaca, which is a steak, egg, and cheese taco, which looks absolutely amazing. And then I also got the chilaquil, which is migas, but with the addition of brown mole sauce. And I totally forgot to get video of me eating these, so sorry if that's your thing, but
if I had to pick a favorite, it is this one for sure. All of the breakfast tacos were $3. We paid $3.50 for the steak, egg, and cheese one. The next time you're in Austin, do yourself a favor and stop at Granny's Tacos. They are super tasty. They are, in my opinion, the best value for money and flavor. So definitely do yourself a favor and stop by.
One thing I was very impressed with across the board was the ability of these places to adapt and go to online ordering. Because yeah, it can be fun to wait in line for an hour or so with your friends, but when you have to do it for barbecue, for tacos, for beer, it's so much more convenient to just be able to order online, pick it up, and then go on with the day and see all the things that you want to see. If you haven't yet checked out my Migas taco video, I'm going to put it up here and in the description below. We make Migas breakfast tacos for way cheaper than all of these places, so definitely check it out. As always, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Make sure to hit the like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll catch you next time.